Well, with tonight being Halloween and all, lots of kids are obviously out trick-or-treating, loading up on all sorts of sweets and treats.
Yes, and that raises the question for parents. How can you avoid a sugar overload, especially after all the parties they probably had at school today? Well, Dr. Lewis First, Chief of Pediatrics with Vermont Children's Hospital at Fletcher Allen, has some tips.
Parents have been bouncing off the wall at playgrounds and other public places, asking me if sugar is to blame for their child's high energy level in these public places. Well, let me calm everyone down and talk about the great sugar controversy. It's natural that since sugar is a high energy food, we would tend to think that it gives high energy to our children. But interestingly enough, sugar is not to blame. There have been 12 studies that cannot show an association between increased sugar content, whether it's from natural sugar, sugar from snack foods, or even in family members who say they're sensitive to sugar, that sugar causes lots of energy or hyperactivity. What does sugar cause? It ends up causing tooth decay and may increase calories to increase your child's risk of being overweight or obese. So why do we blame sugar if it's not to blame? Well, first of all, we only think of our kids eating sugary foods at times where they're revved up, like birthday parties or out on a playground during recess. We never think of sugar, even if our kids are eating a cookie while they're reading a book. And finally, we want to blame sugar rather than perhaps blame our genes or other factors in the environment for our child's high energy. But it's just not true. So what do I recommend? Well, I'm not here to tell you to give your child lots of sugar because, again, it contributes to tooth decay and the risk of being overweight. But instead, if your child is high energy, don't blame the sugar and talk to your child's doctor who can figure out other reasons why your child may have that high energy and in rare circumstances may even diagnose attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. But that's the subject of another First with Kids. So that hopefully tips like this will sugar off any concerns you have when it comes to blaming sugar for your child's high energy level. This is pediatrician Dr. Lewis First from Vermont Children's Hospital Fletcher Allen, having a great time on the playground and reminding you to always be first with your kids.